number figured out. A motive born in drought, in brevity. And if I'm not the soul of your design, I blatantly decline your remedy. Don't box me in. Don't, or I'll leave. I'd rather be a dreamer. I'd rather be.
Greetings, heroes. I'm Hercules 0070, and today we're talking about a ring light. If you have any questions, post your comments down below, hit that thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure you have the bell icon with all notifications clicked. In my description, I have all my social media, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and sharing is caring, so please make sure that you hit the share button and post my link in your social media. So thank you so much for coming and watching, and let's start off with the reflection that you see in my glasses. So, wearing glasses is a hindrance in a lot of different ways in life. But with having a ring light, if I take my glasses off, the lighting is perfect. I like the way that I've set it up. I've actually turned off the white balance on my webcam. I'm using a Logitech Brio for this shot right now. And with turning that off, I can change the hues. So this came with a remote. And in the hue, we can change the Kelvin, so I can actually change the tone, so we can make it more orange or red or brown, whatever you want to call it, copper colored. But because I've turned off the auto settings with the white balance, it looks a lot more orange, just so you can see that, because otherwise the camera will automatically make that orange color become more of a blue or white color automatically. So that's why I turned off the auto settings. So if I make the Kelvin, bring the Kelvin all the way down to the lowest setting on here, that's where we get the opening scene. But right here, when I put my glasses on, I guess that reflection, it's not in my eye, it's on my glasses. It doesn't bother me too much. It might bother some other people, but it doesn't bother me. And that's only if I have the ring light directly in the center of where the webcam's at. So I'm not going to have that because I stream. So I can't have this ring light in front of my monitor. So I'm actually going to bring the ring light up and have it kind of angled above me. So that kind of fixes that issue. And I still feel like I have really good lighting around my face. It's even on both sides, top and bottom. And with me having a beard, it's kind of funny the way lighting works a little bit different with the beard. Sometimes you want the lights a little bit lower, sometimes you don't. But if you had the light directly here, it'll actually bounce off the skin on the bottom and it'll make your beard look more wispy. So I actually like the light to come a little bit from above my forehead a little bit. We have an on and off. See, what the lighting is actually pretty good for this too. We have an on and off setting on there. We have the Kelvin, which is the copper color to the blue color. And then we have brightness, which is the up and down B. This is a really low setting on the brightness, actually. It gets really bright. So that's the top brightness. And then we have a nighttime button on it, which brings it down to the lowest. I believe it's lowest. Yes, the lowest. So you can click between the brightest and the lowest, which is kind of nice. And then you have a quick to the highest copper. And then you have in between. So it's the exact middle between the copper color and the blue color. So we'll go back to this, which is what I like, which is it's also not as bright. So when I'm playing my game, it doesn't take away from me being able to see the monitor properly also, or just being really harsh on the eyes. The super bright, I would say you probably want if you're doing makeup or if you're using it for photography for a product, maybe you can put that above it so you can get more of a harsh shadowing on the edges of the product. But overall, I love that it has a remote. It also has a power cable that goes to the back, and in the back there's a USB port where you can plug in your phone to charge your phone while you're using it so you don't run out of battery. So if you're live streaming on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, some other site, even YouTube, if you're using your mobile device to do a live stream or onto live stream, you can plug your phone in to keep the battery. Or let's say you're doing a really long recording and you don't want your battery to die, that's also very helpful. The power cable is a proprietary power cable, so if you have any problems with the power cable, I don't know what you could do. I would prefer it to be something like USB-C or micro USB or something like that, so that if the cable does have a problem, I could replace it easily without having to deal with the power cable. But otherwise, I mean, it's not a huge deal. It's just a preference of mine. It has three separate attachment points on the bracket where the buttons are. The buttons are haptic touch feedback. So you just touch them. You don't have to actually press a button, which is nice also, because then if you're adjusting it, like if you forgot the remote and you lose the remote or something and you want to adjust it using those buttons, it's nice that it doesn't have the clickiness, so that if you're streaming or you're recording, you can adjust it without having that click happen in your microphone or something like that. On the top of it, there is an attachment where you can put a microphone also. I personally would put the microphone next to the camera because you're going to be talking towards the camera, not looking up. This is a very large ring. I definitely would recommend this, especially for a content creator. If you're a working at home and you're doing a lot of video chats too, this would also be nice. People will definitely notice if your lighting is properly set up. It's kind of frustrating sometimes when you're in like a Discord chat or something like that, and the person you're talking to looks something like this, and you're like, you have the white noise, it's all messed up, it just doesn't look right. But then just a little bit of light, you have a bit of a difference in that, right? It looks pretty good, right? So definitely recommend this for anyone who is a content creator or that uses a lot of websites for chatting, video chatting. So anything that's video or photo related, because this will also help if you're doing like product photography. And let's say you want to put it directly above your product and you want it to be lit from every direction, no shadows. This would work really well for that too. So in the description, Amazon link, definitely recommend this. And I live stream here. So like I was talking about before, make sure you have that bell icon with the notifications, all notifications on, because I don't have a set schedule, but I play Nintendo Switch games and PC games. I love you guys. That's why I call you guys my heroes. I hope to see you soon on my stream. Have a wonderful day.
There's a lot of shots here on our way to the room.
Wait, what, how we just blow up?
We got C4'd.
Are you for real?
That was a pretty good toss.